Lou Kradowski, working the live stream and the HD cam at the same time. Someone, a woman in a car just yelled, "It's my birthday, suck my balls."
Who got the best chance?
The guy that they arrested.
The first guy,
yeah.
Bearded guy.
So for those wondering, Luke here did catch an undercover police officer in Occupy Wall Street. It's on video.
Kind of hitting me, technically.
Yeah. But it's not speculation at this point. Just knowing who and where is the speculation.
That's what I was
doing, police officer. Because actually there's been more videos of him in the street with the police. And with his badge display as well. All right, so we've been going strong.
The bone's been streaming the whole time.
Tim's walking by and this kid just starts hitting Tim. Got it all on video.
Tim, what happened?
No.
I'm standing up on this pathway and the dude who hit me caught on my cord and he said, "Get the fuck out of my way." When I turn around, Patrick Bruner points the light in my face and I held the camera up at him. I say, "He's trying to blind my camera." I tell him it's not working. The dude turns around and just smacks my arm, chops my hand and rips the camera out of my hand, hits the ground. And then I grabbed him. Held him. I don't know what happened to him.
Step up.
Why protesters fighting protesters?
Because they don't want me streaming.
Transparency and
they don't want me streaming.
That's the problem.
You're right, dude. Why don't they want you streaming?
They call me snitch. They said I'm the only one who hasn't been arrested. So therefore, I'm not. Exactly.
I haven't been arrested.
Brandon's not. He's not a cop.
I haven't been arrested yet.
He's not a cop.
He's not a fucking cop.
He's not a fucking cop.
No. Why do you
Dude, just protect me. No. Do the mask.
He's not a cop.
He hit with the mask and he ran away.
He smacked my hand. He chopped my camera and smacked my hand as I was streaming.
Okay,
so I grabbed him, and then other people grabbed him and pulled his mask off. And then he pulled away into the crowd. I don't know what else happened, but...
I saw him get away.
What? I'm still streaming right now, yeah. It was live the whole time when my camera hit the ground.
I got him from behind hitting you on live stream. I got him from behind. I grabbed him too.
So he hit the camera on your hand?
Get on the sidewalk.
Get on the sidewalk. Get on the sidewalk. Get on the sidewalk.
Yeah, I was holding it like this, and he just...
Watch out for the wood. Watch out for the wood.
Rip the cord out. The cord locks into place.
Watch out for the wood.
Everybody, watch out for the wood.
Hey, Laura.
Careful.
Watch the nails, man.
Are you on Tim's channel?
What was that?
What channel are you on?
Timcast.tv.
Okay.
I'm gonna tell you now.
Sure. Yeah. The whole march, Patrick Bruner has been trying to shine an LED into the camera, and it doesn't really do anything. But what happened was, when he did that, I held the camera up, at him shining the light in the camera, that's when the dude turned around and hit me.
You know, you've been around a lot longer than these violent types.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Glad you're right.
Yeah. Yeah, man, I grabbed the guy and let him go.
Brent, he's not a cop, man. He's been with us forever.
Tim Pool's been doing people him. Forever. Ask him.
Of course I grabbed him. He attacked me. Oh, well, you think I'm going to let him go after he hits me?
Well, I didn't know that. Everybody
this dude hits my hand. But I've been getting public threats from these people. What's that?
Everybody was telling me something different.
What? I don't care, man. Look.
People tell me something. Then whatever. And everybody's saying it.
Dude attacked me. Dude, I've been getting threatened by these people for a long time now.
I'm getting your side.
Dude.
That's more clearly.
That's fine, man. It doesn't matter who believes
me.
Dude, it's on video. So just the other day they said Tim's gonna keep doing his thing until he something like he dangers somebody who will correct the situation. You know, in the video of the raid where people are screaming at me and they were, you know, swinging at my camera. This is not a new thing, but I mean, up until the other day when they actually started saying things like. It's just people on. It's this affinity group of anarchists. They're most of the people who were organizing the Black Bloc, it's my understanding. One of the guys, Patrick Bruner, the guy who was shining the LED in my camera, said as the dude was walking forward and said, "Get the fuck out of my way," Patrick said, "I got him," and then he turned the light onto my camera. That's when I held the camera up. The dude turned around and hit me. Earlier in this march, someone came up to me and warned me and said, "I've been warned about the Black Bloc action." They told me to be careful. And then someone came up to me and said, "This person's going to be telling you for protection."
What is their problem with you and transparency? Explain that. What is the issue there?
Well, I mean,
you have a position on transparency that some people disagree with.
Yeah, the way I see it is, if you have an open action, if you are inviting people in, then anybody can see what's happening. Anyone's allowed to see what's happening. But when they have direct action meetings where they allow anyone to come, you have to expect that undercovers are going to infiltrate, in which case the most important thing you can do is broadcast what you're going to do. I understand. I completely understand when people say we can't give away what our action's going to be. But the problem
Don't
is
be the monster.
when that happens,
Don't
is you're
the
allowing
monster.
Them to control what the action will be.
Don't
this woman
be
has also been
monster.
Hounding me for a while now.
Tim, what happened?
Someone just attacked me.
I got pictures of it. A video of it.
I grabbed him because he attacked me, and you hit me. I'm not gonna attack you, but I'm gonna stop
him. Here he is, right here. Look.
He got away.
Look right here. No, I got his face.
I'm not advocating for his arrest. I wouldn't file charges against him. Absolutely, other people can.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but people seem to have taken issue with, did you say that if you witnessed protesters doing something illegal, that you would report it? You would,
I mean,
feel comfortable reporting it with the explain
the actual quote is, when you have anarchists draining police tires who are saying, "Don't film me because I'm doing something illegal, I'm going to film them." I mean, to be honest, that statement came out of my emotional rage, but the truth is, what they are doing, you know, I don't even know how to describe them other than vandals. You could say Black Bloc or anarchists. But when they do things like throwing bottles at police, they put everyone at risk. They are opening the door for the police to start beating and arresting innocent people. And that's what we've been seeing happen this whole time. We've seen two innocent people just grabbed right out of the crowd because the police... When violence opens the door, and they fight back. Thanks, man. And that woman Carrie is yelling at me the whole time too. But they warned me. And
when did this start? This sort of hostility.
The day after the raid, when I caught the people with the draining tires. What happened
after the eviction, the day after the eviction?
Is when they started openly...
November 18th.
No, that was the 15th. The first thing is someone I knew called me and said, "Why did you do that?" And the truth is, if you watch the footage, I did not walk up to a group of people and start filming them drain tires.
Right.
I was walking around a car and I was explaining the name The Other 99. when I hear them yell, I hear yelling. And so all I'm thinking is, hey, someone's yelling, what's going on? I turn the camera and all of a sudden they just rush at me before I had time to even figure out what's going on. And then someone told me that they were draining police tires. And they didn't want me filming or something.
And since then, you've consistently received...
It's been escalating. And this is to the point where they... as I was going to the church today at 6:45, two guys hanging out outside wearing, you know, all black and hoods said, just go home. And Ted said, you really don't like him, do you? And he said, he's a cop. He's the only one who hasn't been arrested. That I don't get arrested?
No, no, not you. The beginning, you have to arrest it and you're not protesting?
I'm not, I don't protest, I don't yell. Alright, so I'm back. Getting back into, the thick of it. The person who hit the camera out of my hand was demasked and photographs were taken of his face. I don't know if he was arrested, but... As I said earlier, I'm not advocating for arrest, or I wouldn't even press charges on him for doing it, but other people are going to.
I'm sorry. Hey, I saw somebody with the nose.
Okay, I have it back.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I just, I didn't know.
So weird.
I didn't know when it was going to happen.
I'm getting, the crazy thing is, I'm getting video of this kid's face, right? I'm taking the mask off, and literally, I have this picture and this video in here. The cops violently grab me and like, throw me into the sidewalk. Violently throw me into the sidewalk as I'm getting video.
Did this happen?
Yeah.
Black dude attacked me.
What? Who did?
A black guy attacked me.
A black cop?
Black.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Attacked you for what?
He turned around and hit my camera.
Oh, I see it.
Yeah. Luke got pictures of him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That guy attacked you.
Really?
I only have the back of the pen. Wait, I'll tweet.
I got pictures.
Oh, you did? Oh, I'll tweet it to you.
Wait, where's the other guy?
He ran off. I grabbed him. He hit me, and then he turned around, and I just grabbed his arm, and I,
What did he hit you for? What did you do?
He walked past me, and he got stuck on this, and I spun around, and he said, get the fuck out of my way.
What the fuck is this guy?
So then I turned around, and
like,
that's nice. When I turned around and started walking again, Patrick Bruner, the tall dude, said, I got him, and then he turned the LED on and up to my camera, this guy right here, and then I held the camera up to his face, because he's been shining the LED in my camera all day, and he actually runs up to my camera and yells things, but I said, you realize it's not doing anything, right? And he's like, I don't care, it annoys you, and then the dude turned around and smacked my hand.
That's bullshit, dude. Is he like known that you've never seen before or what?
No. This guy, yes. This guy hounds me all the time. And then at the same time, after it happened, Carrie runs up to me as well and starts yelling, don't feed the bees.
What happened there,
man? It's a long... This guy walked past me and he got stuck on this cable. And then I got hooked and I spun and he said, get the fuck out of my way. I sort of shrugged it off and I turned around and started walking again. And I was just screaming the front of the march. Like, you know, I'm not mad at the guy for swearing at me or anything. But then Pat Bruner, this dude up here, turned the LED on and said, I got him. And then held the LED up to my camera. It's like the fifth time he's done it today. So I held the camera over it. At him shining the light in my camera, I said, you realize that's not doing anything, right? And he says, I don't care, it annoys you. And that's when the dude turned around and smacked my hand. So. Well, like, and right after it happened, someone starts yelling, I'm a cop.
Yeah, we need a backup too as well.
We're gonna take
Here's another guy that tried to block me.
Yeah, my head hurts.